Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And today, something very exciting is happening, to me anyway. We are now looking at Train Sim World 2's very first steam engine add-on. So, you lot know I've been trying a bit of TS World 2 a bit more recently. This is the culmination of the reason why. I pre-ordered this, you know, I've got no sort of like, you know, ties with DTG, Dovetail Games for like doing this video, because, well, they don't know who I am, which is fantastic, even though I know them previously from, anyway, doesn't matter. So, we're going to be looking at 13. So, this is Crew to Liverpool Lime Street, set in the steam era, and of course you have, two steam locomotives with the add-on. I'm sure there'll be more steam engines added at a future, you know, in the future at some point. But what you get in this is two Stania machines. Everyone knows I love Stania machines. And you get a Stania Jubilee and a Stania 8F. So, I don't know whether this is going to be, like, you know, what sort of stream this is going to be. It's sort of like a first look for me anyway. So I'm going to start with doing, well, actually, do you know what? I'm going to do the 8F and the Jubilee introductions. So we'll start with the Jubilee. I will turn the sounds up eventually, but for now we're just going to go in and we're going to have a look at what the tutorials for the steam engines entail, so that I can learn how these things work, because they're a little bit different, I think, to what I'm used to on normal Train Sim Classic or Railworks. So here we go. What am I going to think? I don't know yet. We will have a look. But oh, look, it's Repulse in the background. 45725. Amazing! That was quite cool. Welcome to Allerton. So, I'm going to talk a little bit over this just in case there's any sort of, you know, copyright, whatever. So, I don't know. I don't think there is, but as you can see, you know, this is sort of giving you a little bit of history on the bottom bit anyway. You know, it's... Yeah, Silver Jubilee, which is actually kind of funny. I thought... I said to one of my friends earlier on, I'm pretty sure... that one of the main, well, not the main reason, but it's kind of ironic that the Jubilee class is in this game. It releases this week, and this week is the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. So that's kind of interesting. So yeah, this is the first time we're seeing actual steam locomotives in Train Sim World, and I must admit, I'm not quite sure what to think yet. I mean, I'm just happy to see steam engine, to be perfectly honest, in the game. So that's quite cool. Can we just press E? Yeah. So here we are. Let's have a look. What we got to do? Take a seat in the seat. Okay. Another window just randomly opened. Passenger ops, apparently. Okay, so... Oh, apparently we can press Y. Did not know that. Okay, cool. I don't know how you do the right side. I will find out at some point. I'm not sure, like, exactly how this is going to roll. Like, I'm not sure how much controllability I have. I think you can open the firebox. But I think the fireman does it for you, mostly. You can also use the bardic lamp there, that's pretty cool. I'm also not sure on the history of this actual model. I'm quite certain this is something to do with, Bossman Games, perhaps. Let's see, press Y to close that. Okay, cool. We're now ready to depart for West Allerton. Right, apparently we're going to get ready to go. Yeah, we know what the reverser does. Apparently, you need to go into full forward, apparently. Whoa, hey! Spinny. And then open a reg. Yeah, okay, whatever. Don't tell me how to suck eggs. You're going to tell me how to suck eggs. No. Steam brakes will apply on just the locomotive. Vacuum brakes will apply on the rest of the train. I think we just got slip. Ha! Let's see if we can do that again. Full power. Wheel slip! Yes! Sorry. Oh, there was a bit of spark action. That was cool. Anyway, let's release the brakes. To create a vacuum for the vacuum. We use an ejector. Yeah, we know. Ah! Why is my camera being weird? So, is there not a keybind for that? Probably is you, I'd imagine. Wait for the vacuum to get to 21. Well, it is at 21, isn't it? I don't know! I don't know what all the things say yet. Well, I mean, we can move, so... We're going. We're leaving. Again, I'm not sure how much controllability I have over this yet. So, I certainly don't think I've got control over the cylinder cocks. Let me find out. I'll press... Actually, I don't know what the keybind is yet. Oh, it's just C. Okay, yeah, I can close them then. I don't know why the tutorial broken already, but, you know, I've opened the brakes and everything. Can I close the ejector? Yes. Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think I might have already broken the tutorial. This is very POG, as they say. I'm sure people don't actually say that. But we'll have a proper go on, like, a summing. I can just wind and reverse the back a little bit, because I now have the imaging work, mostly. Whee! Camera glitch! We love it. Let's just sort of do this. Can we move the flap? No, you can't move the flap. But you have got an up here camera view. I'm very encouraged by the fact that I've broken this already. Okay, you done the doors. I think I might have just opened the doors. Oh no, no, it's fine. We're fine. Do you know what I think? I think I've broken this tutorial already. Because the vacuum is like, you know, done. So, I'm not quite sure what the game wants from me from this point onwards. So, I might have to abandon tutorials. Maybe. Yeah, do you know what? We're going to abandon this because I've already broken it. but I wonder if the AF one works. Shall we go and try the AF one? Yes. I think we should. Because then we can have a look at the AF at the very least as well. And then I'll actually go for a little drive along the actual route. But yeah, so far, what do I think? I mean, it's a train. It's a steam engine. It goes chuff. Yeah. Yeah. Come on, game. Load. At least it's quicker to load this up than it is, you know. Oh, hello. What are we doing for the purpose of this? Welcome to Runcorn Station. I heard the train. Okay. Thanks. Thank you. Also, as you probably noticed, I get a fair bit of lag. I'm not quite sure why, but I'm getting a fair bit of lag. I'm sure it's just like something's on the blink. Probably me. I'm on the blink. I actually am going to get on with some actual driving soon, I think, because I think I pretty much know how these tutorials work, and I'll try and complete them properly in my own time, I think. I guess we'll go on this side because we're going to be picking up the AF from this side. Stand on the platform and wait for your train to arrive. Well, I think I see it. There he is. It's an AF. I mean, graphically, I'm not sure yet. We'll actually have to have a look. But as far as I can see, the stations look alright. At the very least. I think. The 2's a little bit blurry for me though. But yeah, here we go. Here's an AF. It is... Oh, hello. It's 48,000. Very good. Whether that was intentional or not, I don't know. But, so yeah, you get 2 steam engines with this route. AF and Jubilee. I'm going to call it now. I've already called it with my friends and everybody knows what I'm going to say. The next add-on will be a Black 5. Okay, cool. Oh, God. Bear me the history lesson. Let's just go and get in. Yep. Yeah, which you didn't include for some reason. I want the Black 5. I wanted the Black 5. Here we are. Let's prepare the locomotive for departure. Yeah, okay. The reverser determines yeah, the direction of I've literally just done this game. Yeah, so we'll wheel that round. This locomotive has two yeah, okay. Let's just get the brakes open then. Let's use the ejector, because it's going to be the same. Okay, firebox from doing something weird then. Combination brakes apply both types of brakes simultaneously. To create a vacuum for the vacuum brakes. We use the ejector. We know! The small ejector should be left open when the train is running. The large ejector can be used to more quickly. Well, where's the small ejector then? Because that. Oh, small ejector. Let's.
Open the cylinder cocks to remove any water. The regulator acts like the throttle.
Yep. It's you guys have seen how much I drive steam engines. We know.
Applying too much power.
There we go.
Now we're moving. We can open the regulator some more.
Yeah, and I'm going to notch back the reverser because I know how reversers work as well. Oh, wow. Hello. Big viaduct time. I am going to say it. It's nice to see steam engines. Set the regulator to 70%. Oh. Well, I've done it to 100 now. Toward mid gear. Uh-huh. Yeah, what was I going to say? I'm not going to lie. As cool as this is, and it's nice to see. And I'm not sure if this is Bossman Games' 8F. But I still think the one from TS looks a little bit better. Just in my opinion. I don't know, that's my opinion. And my opinion doesn't count. For anything, because I'm just giving this a try. But it is, overall, I'm happy to see steam locomotives in this game. Because TS World, I know at the moment the driving controls are a little bit, let's say simplistic. Because I'm pretty sure that you don't have to worry about the firemen at the moment. And I'm hoping they'll add that at a later stage. But it's nice to have, I'm going to say. I'm not quite sure why the reverser keeps playing up for me. But not sure on the whistles either. Ah, we're about to get hit. We've been hit. We've been hit by wind cutters, apparently. It is nice to watch the valve gear go around nicely, though. Oh, look at that. Okay, so yeah, the lighting looks really good as well. Like, it looks good. I know that's like a slightly controversial thing to just say, oh yes, it looks good because it's got a nice lighting engine, but oh yes, it's that and the other, but, you know, looks... Oh, hello, what are we doing? We're using the combi brake, okay.
Bring the train to a stop in the indicated position.
Maybe I will. Well, actually, maybe I will, maybe I won't, because at the moment, we're not really slowing down that much. But then again, we're on a freight train, and we're on a downhill, so, you know, that's fair. I am going to say as well, the route, though. Yeah. I'm not 100% convinced. I mean, for one thing, and I know this is cliche, I've definitely seen better routes in TS. I look at Golden Age developments and their West of England and all that lot. Purely because I'm looking at the scenery here and I'm thinking it's a little bit bare. A little bit bare. It, in my opinion, I suppose. Right, where are we stopping? Oh, we're stopping here. So that apply the brakes a little bit more. Maybe not. Maybe we need to keep going. I'm going to be a bit like, you know, all over the place here in this, but I'll give like, you know, a proper like, you know, reviewy thing towards the end or while I'm just driving. But, you know, just doing these tutorials. Apart from the fact that I broke the first one, at least the Stanier Mogul, the Stanier 8F one seemed to work alright. And, you know, relatively speaking, having steam engine in the game, it's functional. And again, like I said on one of my other streams the other day, you know, this is, I think, more geared towards console. Therefore, I understand the simplicity of the graphics, like, you know, the scenery anyway, and the, you know. Oh, we've literally slowed right down, no wonder. I understand, like, it's more for consoles and things, but, you know, I think it looks fine. And I'm probably going to get quite a bit of enjoyment out of this, me personally. I will look at the comment section a bit. Oh, I think I meant to stop. Good job I'm going very slowly, isn't it? That should be the end of the tutorial, hopefully. Oh, at least we stopped perfectly at a station.
Great work. Let's see how you did.
Rubbish. Oh no, I did alright. I guess. Well, I got a gold medal, so it's fine. There we go then. So there you go. Broke one tutorial. Passed that one, alright. So I suppose I'd better actually go for a run along the entire line then. So let's take the Jubilee, seeing as I didn't get to run it properly last time. Let's set the time of day to like September clear. And we're going to go... Well, I'm trying to work this out. Because I think you can do that. And then you can do that straight from it. But I'm not really a shunter person. So let's do, I guess, Liverpool Lime Street to London Euston. Because that would be like, you know, the entire length of the line. Jump while it loads. Quick look at the comments. I'm not really going to be able to keep up with all of this. And I'm hoping that this is going to be all right. You know, in general. Like, I'm hoping that people enjoy the stream. And have a look at this from my point of view. But, so we're in a Jubilee. And we're going places. So, uncouple vehicle. What? What am I uncoupling? What? Why am I already uncoupling? Do I have to go all the way down there and uncouple some coaches? Oh, I see. We're uncoupling this Jubilee that just brought it in. Can I do it here? Or do I have to actually physically get out the cab and do it? I think I do have to get out the cab and do it. So, right, let's go for a walk. Let me out. Who have we got? We've got 553. I'm not sure which one that is, but we'll work it out. So, why have I got to walk all the way down to the end of the train to uncouple? Oh yeah, this is Liverpool Lime Street. Big station. Very big. So yeah, we're going to go the entire length of the line. I have set up an additional scenario. Because you can use these, it turns out, in scenario planning mode. And the best place to do it and take the Jubilee over the West Somerset. Although I think I might do it with the 8F. As a demonstration freight. It depends. Because actually this stream I might just do like this route. Because this is what I'm showing off. There we go. Right. So now I've got to go back to the engine and unlock the doors. Why is this my job again? I'm the driver. Drivers don't usually have to walk down to the end of their train. Okay. Also, there was something I noticed earlier on. I'm not sure if it was in this consist or another one, but this is supposedly set in, you know, I'd imagine the late 1960s, because it'd be our late crest. But I saw some crimson and cream coaches. Anyway, doesn't really matter. Let's climb aboard. Let's get back into the driver's seat. Where is it? There. Right. Okay. You unlock the doors. I think. Yeah, there you go. So now I've worked out how to not have to keep using the tab button. This is very egg salad indeed. So let's get set up. And let's find out what... it's too dark in here with my settings, so I can't really see, but... 45553 is like the second of the class. I mean, it's a real shame I'm not going to be able to get either 45690 or 45725, more than likely during the stream. But rest assured, if it pops up in one of these scenarios at some point while I'm driving along in a game, I will definitely be showing that off. Oh, I'm in 8 view, aren't I? Because I wanted to get a shot of us leaving with the jub. So, yeah, looking at it, this is supposed to be Liverpool. And if I look at the map, we're in Liverpool. And this route actually goes quite a long distance, actually. I mean, it's not the longest route I've ever seen. But, again, like, my opinions on the route are slightly different to my opinion on the logos, at least. There we go, objective complete. So now we're going to Edge Hill. So let's find a nice place to get a vantage point. Ah, I'll tell you what, actually, before I do that, I need to open the ejector, don't I? I want a small ejector. I'll have to find out what the, yeah, okay, give me all the achievement for doing things. So, if I close that, okay, no. That's sander. The small ejector is really hard to hover your mouse over, I've realised. Oh, cool. Okay, hold on though. Are you gonna... Nope. The animation is a little bit weird on the manual fireman. Okay. Okay. That's fine. But I think we're in a position that we can leave. Although the game has sort of thrown me into the roof of the building, I think. It did that to me the other day. Bizarrely enough. Anyway, let's get going then. Really? You're slipping? I have to blow her. The damper. Which I can't really control. There we go. We're on our journey. We're on our way. So now we're here. Let's see if we can actually see what name we've got. Canada. We've got Canada, apparently. So, blame Canada, I suppose. Let's sit in the camp for a minute. Link the farmer seems to... Wait. I think the farmer seems to sort of do what he's supposed to do. I'm looking for the... There we go, bardic lamp. Kind of. The animation's a little bit balky, but... You do. I don't want that. Oh, cool. We're like a gradient, aren't we, here? Yeah, again, not so sure about the whistle, though. I mean, sounds Stanier-y. The chuff sound, like, Stanier free beat. At least. So we've got that on our side. Bit strange looking from above here. Especially because you can see the fireman, but not the driver. Ah. Get back into the cab for a minute. Ah, oh, here we go. Bring the reverser back a little bit. Even though we're still on a 1 in 93. Ooh, another chuff coming. Let's go and have a look. That'll be another job coming in. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the Black 5 will be the next loco they do. Hopefully, anyway. Not sure how high the reverser I want. Then again, we are like climbing still, so. We're going to be so bad on time. Boiler pressure, but quite low. This bit is very exciting. Not. No, to be fair, we are almost approaching the next station, so that's fine. Hopefully, when there isn't a 1 in 93 gradient, we'll be able to actually pick up some speed to see what this thing's capable of. Although I'm not really doing much to, you know, prove the fact that steam engines are meant to be quick. Where does this reverser want me to be? Does it want it at 75%? Does it want it at 50%? Does it want it at 30%? I'm doing well in the AF. Maybe I just can't drive Jubilees. Maybe they hate me. I think I know why they hate me as well. Because I always show them in a bad light, don't I? Right, so after the slowest crawl out of Liverpool Lime Street ever, we finally make it to Edge Hill. Although I have just had a thought. I wonder whether that's why we've been losing a lot of steam. I've had the ejector open, haven't I? Can I put the blower open? Yeah, I can. There we go, we're building pressure again now. We made it! Finally! Hooray! I am definitely leaning more towards the fact that, yeah, this is their first steam era route, but I do still think there's a few bits that look a little bit barren, a little bit, I don't know, unfinished in a way. Not unfinished? I'm not sure really what how to, you know, describe it, but unless this is literally what the North is like. I mean, my mate Jordan will probably tell you that the North is North. Whatever, but yeah. Hopefully, now I've got boiler pressure back up, I can close the blower. Hopefully I'll actually be able to make a spirited departure in a moment. I'm still... My brain's still not working properly. Is 45553 Canada in real life? If it is, that's a bit... yeah, I don't know. Doesn't matter. Let's think about leaving. Trying to work out what the other controls do, actually, but yeah, I don't want to, you know. Alright, let's do the ejector. I need to work out what the keybind for the ejector is at some point. Because this is a very slow process! What are you doing?! What are you doing, man?! I don't know what you're doing, but whatever it is, it's really weird. Oh, we got some wheel slip again. Oh yeah, you can see little sparks, that's awesome. Easy does it. Nope. Easy. There we go. We're going to have to make up for lost time now, aren't we? Let's do wheel slip again, because that was cool. Oh wait, no, never mind. It's not going to happen this time. Come on! And now we're out in the sunlight again, so this is nice. Maybe they're just simulating this like the real Jubilee steamed. In real life, when they were first built. Because they were a little bit, interesting. I did close the ejector, didn't I? Yeah. Again, like, I'm not sure where the, whether it actually showed me the water levels and things. I don't think it does. So, I think we have to just sort of play it as if it's almost like, yeah, okay, you're kind of driving a diesel, but as a steam engine. But again, on console, I guess that's fine. But they're pretty. It's pretty. Pretty lighting. Pretty graphics. Yeah? Everyone? Not sure about the green, though. Maybe the lighting engine, I'm not sure, but... Oh my god, not another gradient! Not another gradient! Well, it's a bit rock and roll, isn't it? And now we're... Oh, hello. Hello! I'm finding many things today. Maybe. But yeah, we'll have a look together, everybody, at the route. I mean, like, this is weird looking. Why do I think that there should be some more line-side fencing? It does look a little bit TF defaulty. In a way. Oh my god, what is the pressure on this engine? Just drops. Again, because I can't see whether the injectors are running or not. Like, normally with a steam engine, you can see when the injectors are on or not. Which is usually why the pressure drops. The only way I could really tell is if I look at the water gauges. Can you inject? I think the... the injector controls are all locked out. I think the fire is also kind of locked out too. Can I open the roof hatch? Yeah! I can open the roof hatch at least. And I kind of want to close that door. It's a bit unsafe while we have it on. Can we... Hang on a minute. I just realised something. Our fireman is a fire lady. Okay, cool. Inclusive. You can also open the window. That's fine. You can open and close this one, I think. Oh, weird. Every time I click, the mouse just stops moving. That's very strange. Not the mouse, the camera. Oh, well. Here we go, now we're finally picking up a little bit of speed, but our boiler pressure isn't really doing much. Can I, Is there another keybind for the whistle? I can do the sanders, at least. Turn them off. Ah! We're picking up speed, but a bit of a loss. Oh god, that was a bit bumpy. What's the front look like while we're on the move? Oh. The brake pipe is like fluid. Is that right? Anybody? Somebody in the comments, maybe? Ah. I see we build up some more pressure. Also, like, I need to continue looking at keybind Q. No. L? No. K? I imagine they'll be for injectors at some point. I mean, I'm going to look at the comments, I think. Because there's not really much I can do at the moment while we're running at speed. Apart from look at the scenery. Ah, here we go, yeah. 45553 was indeed Canada. That's fine. And someone put in the comments about the Jubilee being an express version of the Black 5. Well, that's basically what these were there. They were three-cylinder Black 5 with larger diameter driving wheels. They were built to... essentially replace the things like, you know, they're like the evolution of the Claughton and the Patriot and the Royal Scot, I suppose. I'm not a fan of how that smoke is coming out of the chimney. Anybody else? Again, me being honest, I'm not being paid to do this or anything, so my honest review of that, that chimney smoke looks very strange to me. It sort of looks like a vapour. Yes, we get it, Jubilee. You vape. It doesn't look fantastic. Maybe one day we'll get some proper... well, I don't know. I'm hoping we'll see Caledonia Works maybe make steam for this game eventually. If DTG actually, you know, release development tools for it. But, you know... Despite any negativity, I do actually kind of enjoy the fact of driving steam train. But I can't deny there are some sort of, like, you know, quote-unquote faults. It's nice to see the engine swaying about a lot, though. But I need to definitely look at what the keybinds are as I explore playing this game a little bit more. Also, my frame rates are dipping quite badly. Don't know if anybody else can see that on the stream. But I don't normally get this much lag on Train Sim World, so I can only imagine it's the particle effects. Or the amount of wobbly. Oh, at least you've got nice reflections in the cab. Fire Lady is doing a thing. I'm not going to look at that. There's a yard over there. But yeah, it's a pleasant enough place to be, I suppose. If it didn't lag so much. Hopefully, oh god, we are literally not going to make it on time. I've just looked at the timetable. We are going to fail miserably at this, I'm afraid. So, someone just said it does look like source particles. I didn't realise that there was a... Huh. Yeah, there we go. There are people actually telling me in the comments. I'm very sorry I'm not able to read all of them. I am trying to look at them. But people are making some good points of feedback. I mean, I'm hoping that by just me showing you guys what this is like, you can come to your own conclusions on what you think of this. I think overall I'm going to say that I'm not a big fan of the route, purely because it doesn't look very highly polished. And there's a couple of things with the loco that I'm not, you know, fully on board with. But again, for a representation of Steam in Train Sim World, I'll tell you what, for a laugh in a bit, because I've obviously got motion blur turned off. I wonder what those wheels will look like if I put motion blur on. Oh god, should we try? We're gonna try. If I can change that option in here, we're gonna try that. What do I want? I think I want advanced settings. What do I want? Motion blur on. And then apply. Let's see what that looks like. Yes! I'm imagining awful. Let's see. Oh! No! Okay! Alright, I thought it'd look worse. Maybe they've improved the motion blur. But it still doesn't look right, does it? Although that does look pretty... I don't know, actually. I'm kind of enjoying that. Look, like, as comparison, like, look, we've got the motion blur going. Although, I have noticed that there seems to be sparks with the motion blur on. Let me just turn the motion blur back off. Sorry, everyone. I'm literally exploring with dark on settings in the SHID. Motion blur off. Okay, apply. Okay. I'm not quite sure how much of a difference that's going to actually make. Is it still sparking as we go along? Yeah, it looks like it's either sparking for no reason, or maybe it's supposed to do that. I'm not sure. But you know what? I'm going to say something really quickly. I'm going to put the motion blur back on while we do this, because actually, do you know what? I think it actually looks alright. Personally, makes it look a little bit more fun, I suppose. And yes, I know we're speeding quite badly, and I know that we're rocking and rolling everywhere, but having a little bit of fun, aren't we? Let's have a look at this. Oh, I see. Yeah, I'm just looking at someone called Seaboard. Simulation seemed completely put together. Motion blur was redone specifically for this. Sparks are because you're slipping. Okay, I didn't even realise I was slipping. Alright. Cool. Oh yeah, it does say I'm slipping. I think... Because I know steam engines have a lot more... although I'm quite happy that we're doing 90-odd in a steam engine. Oh shoot, there's a 55 speed limit. Let's slow down a bit. I can see myself enjoying this, even though it's not, like, you know. It's not mind-blowing, but I can see myself getting enjoyment out of this, and I think that is the, that kind of the best I can say. At least it's something I'm pretty sure I'm going to enjoy. And the motion blur does nothing for me when we're at lower speeds, I guess. Also, I don't mean to come across so critical for anybody wondering. I just feel like in this business, I have to be honest. Like I say, I am enjoying it. I just think that, I mean, I'm looking at the scenery over there. Could look like that in real life, I don't know, but... Oh, I've got to open the ejector again, because I wasn't going to stall. Which I think, actually, we are going to stall. I completely overestimated that. I want a gradient. Why did I do that? I'm a dauber. Keep saying that word. I'm not quite sure what that word means. Same as Scottish, I think. So there we go, everyone. We've managed to slow right down. I really need to work out what that keybind is later. I'm not going to do it while on stream, because I've already been messing around with settings too much. But hey, Violet. Does feel very classic, I'm going to say classic DTG slash RSC, though. I mean, what was I going to compare this to? Well, compare this in TS World 2, like, after obviously having done all the diesel routes, electric routes, and whatnot. Compare this to the original S&D that was in Kuju's Rail Simulator, the original. This does look a lot better, but then again, technology has come a lot further in that time. So... I'm not sure where I'm actually going to sit on this one, because I'm enjoying myself. I'm very much enjoying seeing and playing with a steam engine in TS World, because, like, you know, contrary to popular belief, I do actually kind of like TS World, but there are still some things that definitely need tweaking in future, and I think they need to, like, you know, this will be a good experience, but I wanted to show that The community does want steam engines. This is what railways are all about to me. And a lot of people I know in the community. And this actually may bring more people in to play this game. I'm especially hoping that one of my friends is watching this right now. Because I said to them that we've been waiting for a long time for steam to come to TS World. And I don't know what his impression is going to be. I'm hoping it's positive. Or at least something that you can just pick up and play, perhaps. But... yeah, I don't know. I'm enjoying it. Despite the fact that I clearly can't drive steam engines for toffee. The other thing I did notice, actually, kind of interesting, is that this hasn't got a reverse, like, you know, there isn't a reverse... Yeah, you can see it moving there, but that hasn't got a keybind for the reverse lock. So it has indeed been simplified. But then again, that should hopefully bring people in who might not necessarily know all the ins and outs of driving steam engine, but want to try it. So this actually, I think, is quite a clever move from DTG. Although, thinking about it, now if... It is my... I mean, like, obviously me, as a railway enthusiast, as a steam engine enthusiast, I love the fact that it's Stania Jubilees and Stania 8Fs, and I imagine the first add-on pack going to be a Black 5. Gotta be. If it isn't, I will be very surprised. But I'm also kind of surprised there isn't a 4F. Or, you know, maybe... I'll tell you who would have been really good for this game, Mesh Tools. You know, because they, right, I think they were working on a Fairburn tank in Unreal Engine. And to see a Fairburn tank in this would be quite interesting. In fact, I wonder... I wonder if a Fairburn tank might come to TS World in the future for this route. Because that's LMS. Ooh, Tom, you sly dog. I'm going to put that down as a prediction. Stania Black 5, yes. Maybe... This is the station. Yeah, this is the station. Maybe a Fairburn tank, because I have seen progress on that. Like, in the past. And I don't know whether DTG still have contact with the guy from Meshals, but maybe. That's quite a bold prediction, I know. I mean, I don't even know whether they're going to continue with steam stuff. I hope they do, because I'm sorry, but if they continue to build steam engines for TS World, I will more than likely continue buying them. Because this might not be the most impressive product I've ever driven. Like, this isn't the most impressive route. One of the most impressive routes I think I've driven in TS World is probably... I've got to think about this now, actually, because I might not be impressed with this route as other routes, but what is... I mean, I like driving to West Somerset, but I'm also... I also kind of like driving... what's that other route? Oh, the Trans-Pennine. Trans-Pennine was very good. I liked Trans-Pennine a lot. Ah! I can take a steam engine over Trans-Pennine, can't I? That is very good. I like that. Yeah, I like that. I think that's a cool idea. Oh, someone should put, they want an LNWR engine. Super D! Put a Super D in this game. Yes! That would be very cool. Someone in the chat is asking if I'll do Machine Rail Sierra Railroad number 3. No. Probably not, because I don't really have that much interest in it. But, yeah! Oh, hello, Chris has put a comment. Oh no, it's not Chris. It's, I read Victory Works as Victorian Lad. I'm very sorry. So Victory Works has put, when Matt played, crew at 1300 being completely dead for 10 minutes was a real turn-off. That would be, that, yeah! Do you know what that would be? Because I'd like to see more action. If they had more AI rocking around. Because at the moment, I don't really think I've seen much AI. So, actually, yeah, completely agree, Victory Works. Pete, isn't it, I think? Pete? Yeah, it would be nice to see a little bit more AI. Yeah. It's actually kind of interesting. I've had Victory Works watch a stream of mine. That is very interesting. Because... I don't think I've seen him on my channel before. I did see another, like, quote-unquote famous personality pop up. Where was it? Laserjet popped up as well. Hello to him as well. I'm not quite sure why you're watching my stream, mate, but I'm nowhere near as big as you. But yeah, Victor Works has also said, I was looking forward to train spotting, but the timetable's really empty. I would like that a lot. I do think this needs more... Oh god, slippage. Actually, this is going to sound really stupid. I actually really like slipping. Come on, do it again! Yeah! Anyway, let me get back to actually like being sensible, because someone literally just... I think anyway, someone just said... Well, Victor Works just said that they... I wanted to see the opinion of someone who knows about trains. I do know about trades, yes, but... Oh, what's going on? Why are you, what have I done wrong here? Right, more reverser, less reg, let's make a spirited departure. I'm not opening the Sin of the Cox again. There we go. So, yeah, I'm not quite sure what to say now. I feel, like, very weird, like, knowing that people that I look up to are watching, because I do look up to Victory Works. Obviously I do, because a lot of the characters I use in my show are Victory Works. I say a lot. I've used other ones. One of the main characters, anyway, because I see Goose as the main character. And also, you know, I think other products, whatever, but yeah. I better stop being all giddy. I'm very sorry. And get back to actually, like, you know, talking about this product. I need to clone that. Yeah. Ah, oh, we'll find out that keybind. You can imagine that I'm also probably going to be using... Obviously, I want to take these over to West Somerset. I can imagine me taking a Jub-Jub over on the main line. Now, something actually I think that I want DTG to actually implement into the game is a consist builder. I don't know whether there is one, but I'd like to be able to make up my own consists like you can in TS. DTG, or someone at DTG, if you ever watch my stuff, please get on that. Actually, I don't know. Please don't watch my stuff, because then you'll tell me not to ever stream your stuff ever again. Maybe. But those smoke effects... Oh, hang on, wait a minute. Wait a minute. What did I just see? Is there another bridge? Yes. I want to see if this is a thing that occurs. Because, let me just reverse back a little bit. If I just saw what I thought I saw, it's a feature I've wanted in TS for such a long time. And that is, does smoke just go through the bridge? We'll find out in a minute, because I want to see if that's a thing that occurs. Oh, okay. Apparently I've only driven 10 miles in the Jubilee. Oh, God. I can imagine that total going to go up a lot. Right, more reg, less reverse. It would be good to be able to control the fire, though. But that smoke, tell you what, that smoke effect, though. I'm sorry, to anybody at DTG, you do need to look at that, because that does not, that looks a bit like, oh, I don't even know. Anyway, let's see, does it do it? No! No! I have been greatly disappointed, 0 out of 10. Not playing anymore. No, I'm joking. The particle effects are awful, like, there's no doubt about it, they're not great, very good, but the fact it clips still through, like, bridges and things, that upsets me a little bit. And I know that sounds bad, but it does. Just a tad. Anyway, I'm going to have a little read of the comments for a second. Oh, the ejector's a J with control and shift for large. I might try that in a minute, actually, because that would be good. Wonder if Train Sim World will have a route builder. I hope so one day, because then I'll build the DR. It does bounce off bridges, even though I'm sure I just saw it not. Oh, Glen of Creations is also here. Hello, God, all the people are coming out tonight. Glen of Creations says, doing it right, Tom. Do you reckon that even with steam engines that you'll ever switch to TSW without a route editor? Well, I think I'm going to use TS... This is my stance. I'm going to use TS World for more casual stuff. You know, for like if I just want to do a casual-ish drive, you know. And mainly for the graphical fidelity, because it is basically like a more graphically upgraded TS. But I'm not going to come out of TS as in, you know, Railworks completely, because one, I rely on it for my shows that I make. Secondly, there is much more customizability. Three, the communities involved in TS itself, like, you know, the route build communities, the asset building communities, the loco building communities, all that lot, you know, they're huge and there's a lot going on all the time. There's always something going on with Train Sim. But because TS World is very closed off, I see this as sort of me not switching completely over to this. What am I doing wrong? My boiler pressure is tanking. I've not even... Oh my goodness, the simulation, I'm not... Is it because of the injectors? Ah, there you go. Yep, okay, that's fine. And then the small ejector. Yep, there you go. Thank you, thank you, Peter Victory Works, for that. Now I know what the keybinds are. Which means I can close the small ejector a little bit. Don't need to be fully open. That might help with steam, actually. This is a shame. I was doing really well earlier on. We were, like, you know, barreling along. And now we're on a gradient. I've lost all... Have I lost all my... Where's the boiler pressure gauge? It's up there. I know it's, like, down there. But I want to actually look at a proper pressure gauge. That ain't the pressure gauge. I'm on the driver's side, so where's the... Ruddy pressure gauge. Is it on this side? Ah, of course the fireman. Oh God, no wonder we're down to like 140-ish PSI? I don't know why I said it like that. God, blower? Blower's open. Oh, wait, hang on. No. No! What do you mean I can't control the blower? Oi, you lady, open the blower. We'll just fire again. In a really weird way. Man, I miss the days where Chris managed to actually animate a... he actually managed to animate the coal going onto the shovel and going into the fire. DTG, why can't you do it? Blowy, blowy, blowy. And slow, slow, slow. This is... Oh my goodness. Come on! I don't believe you! Like, I think you're lying to me. 45553. Jubilee. Built between 1934 and 1936. Not doing the dark tries on the Jubilee. We've done that already. If Bopham Games is watching, please. Would you please release the light specifics for TS? What? Oh, it's a reflect... I'm looking at the rail joint at the very front and the bottom of the screen. And I'm wondering why it's red. It's the reflection. That is... One of the cool things about the graphical fidelity of the game. If you could get the graphical fidelity of this game right? And then, you know, the content from Train Sim Original. Home run, like, I'd love it, but I know it's not possible, sadly. Because we're going so slow, I'm just gonna have a look. Oh, hello. Oh, you can set the fireman to be semi-automatic. You can control blowers and that. Right, this is stuff the tutorial does not tell you. Where do I go for that? In the settings, I guess it's in controls, is it? I probably misread where it was. Was it here? No, hang on. I'm going to have to click back to the stream a sec. Oh, it's in game. Steam firing mode. Right, okay. Sorry! You know what? Being partly blind, sometimes looking at these menus does not help. Ah, here we go. We want... Oh, you can do manual! I don't know whether I want... Should I try manual? Let's try manual. I don't know what the settings are, but I can open the dampers at least. I don't know whether I could do the injectors. I think I... Steam heating? What? Steam heating? I thought they would... Maybe I'll just put it to semi for now. I normally am quite confident, but I'm not sure that I'm that confident yet. Let's do assisted then. Let's do assisted. Let's just play it safe for the sake of the stream. Maybe I'll try it properly at a later point. Right, they haven't finished the firing side. Right. I see. Yes, I kind of knew that already. But I honestly did think, oh, manual. Does that mean you can do all of the things? But at least I can have the... Okay, so the blood assisted... do you know what? It's fine. We're picking up speed again because we're on a downhill. Unless... No. Okay, do you know what? I want to get the blow on. So, steam firing mode. Manual. Apply. Let's see what happens. Because I need to get that boiler pressure up. Problem is, I can't really see whether it's making any effect. I need to look at steam generation. But it's going up. I'm on a downhill so we can cope for a minute. Look at that, see? We're gaining pressure. Once we got it back up to 225, I'll open it up again. Hopefully. Thank you, Bitchwiz, for that. I would have probably not known that for a little while if I hadn't have asked. Sorry to be a massive pain. Right, here we go. Close the blower. I'm going to keep the dampers fully open. Bring the reverser back. There we go. Now we're cooking with gas. Is that the term? I don't know whether that's the term. I wonder if there's I didn't know whether there was a keybind for the... I'm not going to keep asking, actually, because I'm going to get annoying if I keep asking what keybinds are for what. I'll just have to look it up myself. Let's see. Any more things I can read out while we're going along? Officially coming soon, Cornwall. If they opened TSW up for more third-party stuff and actually made the root editor that showed off a while ago public, would give more people incentive to invest in the game. Completely agree, Riley. I think if we could edit roots and things, I think that would be a lot better. Apparently, the main fireman, according to Richard Wilson, due in future trademark, so we'll see about that, whether that happens or not. Collective Creations, I feel many TS creators have put so much time and effort into those creations, unless they can be ported over to TS Classic will still be used. Again, agreed. Have they used proper sound this time? I have no idea. I can now control stoking by opening the fireman's doors, however, there's no way to see the coal level. That's no good. 4 minutes down, thanks, Mrs. Fireperson. Yes! I'm doing so poorly at this. Actually, I don't know. Let's have a vote. Is it my fault that we're doing so badly, or is it Mrs. Fire Lady? I'm going to say it's me, because this is the first time driving the jobs in a game. And also, I have to say this, actually, because me and a couple of friends... Actually, funnily enough, on Glenlick Creations' Scotch racetrack route, me and my mate Freddie, who was on the last stream I did, we were looking at it, and he was trying to get the Jubilee, the Bothman Game Jubilee, to work, and... yeah, sadly, he can't get it to steam very well. And then I tried it, and I also struggle a lot with the Jubilee. But, I mean, this one's struggling a wee bit, but I'm putting that down to it being teething troubles. You know, first team loco they've simulated in the game. But, DTG, you've done this before. Like, as RSC, you've done steam engines before. You know what you're doing. Yeah. I mean, I know other people have come along and, you know, much, much more advanced with, like, how to do steam engines and things, but... Oh, we're doing 69 cheeky mods now. See, again, apart from the route being a little bit barren, I'm enjoying the idea of driving a steam engine. I'm also very grateful to anybody who is actually watching tonight. Cheers. I know I'm not the most entertaining streamer. I don't normally stream ever, but I really... Like, as soon as I knew that this was coming, and I knew it was going to involve Stanley machines, I was like, I've got to stream it. Like, I've got to do something. Oh my giddy aunt! Hang on, we're in the race. I've just seen we've got another steam engine up ahead. Ready for this, everyone? Ready? We're going past. And... Wait for it. Loser! Look at that. Fantastic. Why are you going so slow? And what number are you? 45604. You are... Salen? 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 I think Salen. But look, now look at us going along. We're motoring. All because I, put the, How are we wheel slipping at this speed? Stop it. That's the other thing. I wish the camera wouldn't clip into things as you're going along. I like these sort of views. You guys see me doing this view all the time. It does look so pretty. Like, see, I don't know if anybody else has this, but as a child, and as a, well, even now, actually, I say as a child, but my fascination as a child, I love watching Valve Gear. And watching Valve Gear this smooth and with the motion blur, it just sort of makes me feel like... It's really weird. I don't know how to describe it. It feels really cool. Even though I know like it's completely unrealistic and the smoke is sort of annoying me a little bit now. But it's nice to watch your Algae go around, is it not? At high speed. Did the eccentric rod move? Yes, it does. Good. The eccentric. It's not the eccentric, is it? It's the bit. The bit. Let me show you what I mean. Like this bit here, the bit between the front and the actual like Wolfshark's Valkyrie bit. God, somebody help me! You know what bit I'm talking about. The bit is moving forward and backward like it should. And also, I just noticed the mechanical lubricant is also rotating around. Is that cool as well? How far have we actually gone? We are there. Okay, so it's like a nice long straight bit to crew now. So we've got to stop at the next station. Oh, those are a bit of a weird graphical glitches there on the track on our left. Eee. I'll say how much we could squeeze out of her. Right. We have got to start thinking about slowing down now. Damper closed. We'll turn the blower, the front damper off. I just noticed those little icons down the bottom there, next to the steam pressure and steam shaft. I'm not quite sure what they are. Is that the... Oh, that's the blower. What's the little cloud one at the bottom then? I don't know, but I better start braking, if we're like... This is all stuff I will find out eventually. So we're approaching Hartford. So what I'd like to ask you in the comments, actually, because I know I've been gushing about the fact we've got a steam engine, but what of the route? I mean, it's nice to have a steam mirror route in TS World, but I'm definitely thinking scenery-wise, there's a lot to be desired. Just in my professional opinion. Doing the ejector. Ah! We got stuck in the scenery! We are actually stuck in the scenery. Wrecked. There we go. Better. Well, we made it to this station. So what did I do? I had all the dampers and ejectors open. I'm trying to learn the controls. So, right, small ejector closed. Right, close that. Close that, because we don't need them open while we're at the station. Let's get a... I wanted to get back to a comment, actually. Because, again, I really haven't seen that much in the way of AI. This route is probably screaming from AI. Hopefully, if they add more steam locos into the game that are appropriate for the region and time period, which, let's face it, in pretty much anything at this point, let's hope then that they'll increase the amount of stuff on the timetable. With fingers crossed. What's all going on in the comments? Mad Duck says, the whole thing looks a bit off. Adam Bridgewater, route looks a bit meh. I like the route, just needs improving. Ordered some steam fell on the other day to get hot experience, smell of burning lemon. Eww. Factory made a route that isn't TSC in 2021 Classic was a good move. Yeah, that's fair. I'm the route builder here, also don't need a pilot's license to be able to tell when someone's doing a poor job of it. I'm not sure whether that's a response to me or someone else, but I don't know. If they develop software so old for locos can be imported, TS locos can be imported, that would be fantastic. Let's see. Yeah. I get you. I understand. I'm going to say something to that, wasn't I? I don't remember. I'm going to say something. Right, J, let's open the large ejector. Open. Oh, no. Ejector. Release. Small ejector open. Cylinder cocks. Oh, they don't see that when you open them. When I opened them, a little puff of smoke came out. We're on a downhill, so hopefully we should be right to start off this time. Come on, brakes. The smoke particles coming out of the cylinder cock, so they look alright to me. Alright, let's see if I can remember this. Small ejector fully open. No. And then shift J. There we go. That's a large ejector closed. I really want this to work. In all honesty. I don't know whether I'm looking through rose-tinted glasses. But as much as there are some definite problems, I would like steam to be a thing in Train Sim World. Just because it's... I mean, open up the first... I mean, RSC, DTG, whatever you're called now, open up the... I think you should open up the third-party software editing and let the community have a go. Because I think everyone... There's so much talent out there. They could probably really bring a lot to this game, I reckon. I mean, this is a good first step. It's good to see that we've got steam engines in the game working. And there is some functionality. But if the third-party developers were involved, route builders, sound modifiers, engine builders, asset builders. I think this could be this if this was opened, cracked open to third party, this could be the next train sim, like Railworks, I reckon. But they need to open it up. Get the dampers on. Because we're what is our next stop? Crew. You know what they say about crew? Should I say it? I wonder if someone in the comments will pick up on what I'm saying. Maybe. I don't know. But they're my opinions. My opinions are, I'm enjoying the fact we got steam. The route isn't the best in the world, but I think I will probably get used to driving it and I'll enjoy it all the same. At the end of the day, it's DTG. We know that DTG's route's a little bit basic to give it a nice... Because I don't want to... Don't want to go off on one and be, like, mean. Because, again, I understand the situation. I understand that this is a game built for console primarily. And I say primarily. I think people who know me know what I'm talking about. I don't want to be overly harsh. And I love the fact that they actually went ahead and did this. Because at the end of the day, if they hadn't have done this... Like, I don't think I would have reinstalled Train Sim World, if I'm honest. Because I reinstalled Train Sim World not long ago, when I heard that this was coming. And I'm not going to lie, this is the reason I reinstalled it, and this is the reason I bought this at full price. Next time, not sure, I may, depending on what it is, I may hold off next time for a sale, because this will probably get me going for a while. I mean, I can still go back to Train Sim if I want to drive up steam engines anyway. Besides, like, you know, as we've seen recently, we've got other loco coming out soon. I mean, Victory Works, who's here in the chat. Hopefully, his War Department 210 for Train Sim Classic. I hate calling it Train Sim Classic, but Railworks. That should hopefully be coming out, I think, soon, depending on SSS. Caledonia Works got the U-Boats coming at some point. Who else is developing? I mean, you've got Machine Rail develops things. Loco-wise, I'm obviously following a lot of Golden Age developments in their route building because they're, you know, exquisite. Bothman Games. Unrebuilt, original condition Light Pacifics. Literally, there will be a video on that when that comes out. No doubt in my mind that I will be like, I will be in there. But there's so much talent. And if DTG could invest in that talent by just unlocking the game, they're holding the key. And there's a lot of people out there who could, you know, there's a lot of people out there who'd like to jiggle that lock. I mean, crumbs, I'm thinking about people like Vulcan Productions Ash. I mean, if VP Ash ever watches this, if you could sort them smoke particles out, that'd be amazing! So, you know, again, like, back to my point. Essentially, I get where they are. I get what they've done. I appreciate what they've done. I'm enjoying it. I will enjoy this route. I'm not going to give this a scathing review, but I'm going to go in the middle of the road. I'm going to just go... I think that's really my opinion, really. Middle of the road. Enjoying it, in my own personal sense, because it's Jubilees and 8Fs. I will take an 8F out after this, I think, because I've still got about an hour and a half until I've got to think about wrapping up for the night. But the route itself, it needs more AI. It needs more scenery. But I understand the situation where it needs to have, I don't know why that's still fully open. There we go. Oh, hell, I need to open it a little bit, don't I? Yeah, but you guys hopefully get what I mean. I'm going to enjoy this add-on. I am enjoying this add-on. I'm liking the fact that I can drive a Jub-Jub in Train Sim World. It's not a Black 5. I'd have much preferred to have seen a Black 5. Purely because Black 5's are my jam. And also it would have been nice if I could change what number the loco is. I don't even know whether that's a possibility. I'm sure somebody knows how to do that. Because I'd love to be able to drive the Jubilees I like rather than just a random one each time. But those smoke effects, man. I don't know how they passed. Middle of the road. That's what I'm going to say. If anyone wants to sum it up for me, if I'm going to sum it up, middle of the road. That's it. That's really... That's really all I've got to say, I suppose. Someone puts SRU Watt class. I don't know whether they mean like, and they're trying to make a joke about the U Watt, or whether they're like, you know. Oh, hello. WD210O is in final testing. Next loco is in research mode. Very poggers. Very nice. I look forward to driving the 210Os when they come out, Victory Works. I'm assuming that I've already seen Dame Vera Lynn, the one that's on the North York Moors, that's going to hopefully be with it. In the pack. I will enjoy that. Also, Gordon. Yes. Very, very nice. Yeah, Victory Works. Yeah, do you know what? I agree with that. It's classic DTG. Good, but could be better. Yeah. You know what? If they open this up for modification, and someone could mod, like, do, like, you know, a scenery mod and, you know, a loco mod and whatnot, I think that would be really cool. I think that would be quite cool. What's missing here is other trains coming in the other direction. Like, in all seriousness. Where are they? Can we get up to speed? I'll tell you what would be interesting, actually. Running this route with a diesel. Maybe I'll do that at some point. I haven't really talked about the sounds much. Have I, really? Alright. I do like how the steam clips into the cab, though. I just saw that. People can make their own minds up, I suppose, on whether they want this or not. If you like steam engines and you like have TF World, or haven't really got much of a choice, but to place Train Sim World, if you're on console or something, yeah. It's a decent enough representation of what steam engine is and does, and it looks pretty as well. If you're a diehard rail, like, you know, railway enthusiast, like, you know, like me, you're probably gonna find the faults. But yeah, again, not really a lot else I can add. I'm just enjoying it for what it is, and I definitely think this part of the route is a bit, what is it, crew to run something. It's a bit boring and straight. But then again, this is like the West Coast. Is it the West? Yeah, this is the West Coast Main Line. What am I talking about? Of course it's the West Coast Main Line. Would have been interesting to see Liverpool to Manchester. Oh man, do you know what would have been awesome? If DTG had done Liverpool to Manchester, but in the 1800s, with like Rocket and Sampere and Locomotion. Oh look, I just saw an AF go by. Way! Way! Meow! Finally, a bit of AI traffic. That was pretty cool. Sorry. Oh yeah, I forgot you could do this camera. I actually forgot. Oh man. Oh yeah, that will make a cool screenshot, I reckon. If I get rid of the HUD. Let's wait until there's something a bit scenic. But you can actually get right down to the wheels. This is awesome. Let's see, let's see. Let's move back a little. Let's wait until we're near that bridge. Boom! Screenshot taken. What other detail can we look at while we're on the move, actually? I mean, how far have we got? 4 miles to go? I do fancy looking at it in the light that the tender is a slightly different colour to the loco. Just to be pedantic. I like the grime. I like the mechanical lubricator. I still can't work out whether I'm making the wild assumption that this is indeed the Bochum Games AF Jubilee put into this. But I could be wildly wrong or wildly right, who knows? Bochum Games knows. Train Sim Dovetail Games knows. Probably everyone except me knows. Why is that smoke so off-putting? What's it remind me? Do you know what? Actually, do you know? I've just worked out what the smoke effects remind me of. Transport Fever 2. The smoke effects on the steam engines in Transport Fever 2. That's what that reminds me of. The way they just puff out randomly. But come on, like, you know, even the hardest of skeptics can't deny that watching the steam engine rocket, rocking up and down as it speeds along the main line, That is a nice sight, isn't it? I could probably just sit and watch this. I honestly could, probably. Should make a GIF of it and make it my screensaver or something. What we'll do in a minute, we'll go back to the AF, I think, once we get to crew. For anybody who didn't get it earlier, crew, a fine place for sick engines. They can give you a new shape and a smaller firebox. Wait, that's wrong. Oh, crumbs, there's a 20-mile power limit coming up. So after the end of our high-speed run, I think, we're going to start slowing down a bit now. While we do so, I'll have a quick look at the comments section. I do hope people enjoy this, by the way. Yeah, I do hope so. I know, again, like, I know I'm not like the biggest YouTuber out there, but I do feel passionately about this. Hang on a minute. Hang on a minute! I've just seen someone in... Oh my goodness, I feel really bad now. Train Simulator themselves are watching. I feel slightly terrible now. In fairness, if they do watch back, at least I've been honest. And it's not like I've completely... Oh my goodness, there's lots of lag in here. I think it's because the termini are probably quite big. Yeah, do you know what? We're not making that speed limit change. I really hope it isn't a red signal, otherwise that's the end of our run before we've even finished. Actually, I don't know, maybe. I will have a look at Train Simulator themselves' comment. As Train Simulator, for anyone who knows, is Dovetail Games, builders of the game. I am quite interested to read that comment. Although, from what I remember, I think it was something about the auto fireman. Oh my god, the next signal is red. But it's the end of the station, so it's fine. Oh god, we did not do very well there. I got so distracted. I need to go back and look at that. I need to go back and read that. Train Simulator. Farming being worked on at the moment. We'll update when we have more information on it, but can control dampen, blower, and when the fireman puts in coal. Thank you very much. That is fine with me. That is a decent response. And yes, according to the guys, it is indeed the Bossman game model. Someone's asking me to sound the whistle. Gotta catch up. DTG's reimagined the 1958. What's up, TS? I am indeed. At least you've been honest. Yes, I've tried to be as honest as I can. Ah. So yeah, intriguing. I finally hit the big time, maybe. Nah. What is going on with the sound on that safety valve, though? It sort of, like, makes weird things. I don't know what to say now. I don't know whether to feel awful or thrilled. I don't know. At least if Train Sim are watching, I am enjoying your product. Apart from maybe the sound of the safety valve going ba-deh, ba-deh, ba-deh. But at least I made it to the place where we can get rebuilt. Maybe because I've like literally used up... Hang on, is that boiler pressure maybe? Is that the boiler pressure gauge at the bottom? Maybe. Right, let's stop here. This will be fine. Maybe. I don't know actually. No, I'm going to try and get right to the end of the platform. Now I'm going to try and wheel slip as well while we're coming in. Yeah, there we go. At least that's animated and it works. Right, this will do. Let's stop. Oh, hang on. No, there we go, unlocked. So that's the first part of what we're doing. Probably got another hour or so to go. I'm going to quickly have a look at the comment section. Let's see. Uh, What's the Wilson physics like? Yeah, right. I've just read a comment that I want to see the context of. I don't know. But yeah, there is a little slip. I don't... Richard Works has said, I'm going to screw this word up. Ahistorical nature of the footplate crew. I'm not sure what that... I think that means because it's a female on the footplate. I'm sure that's not a problem, though. Oh, blow into the bottom left, dampers top left, pressure gauge, beam gauge, bottom gauge, steam shaft. Ah, yes, that does make sense. There we go. There we go. That's the dampers. And I can control the rear dampers. Okay, cool. Why is it still saying that the doors are locked? Oh, I think I've opened them now. It's fine. So that was the first part of our run. I will take the 8F out. And then I don't know what I'll do after that. Link down there what the little gauges and things do. That's very good. Thank you. I think it was Jamie from Tracing for that. Cheers. I better read some more stuff while... could you zoom out so we can see crew in its entirety? Of course. Let's see if I can... wait, if I press the 8 view. There you go. So here is crew station. End of the line for now. There you go, if anybody wanted to see. I recognise that asset! I've literally used that asset on the DR. There's one of them at Mercum Sheds. Jeez, that's cool. Then again, I suppose there are some more. I mean, it obviously is easier to have assets from TS in TS world. But, yeah. So there we go, we did that run. Ignore the graph. We failed miserably. As you can see, because I only got a silver medal. So that was that bit. Let's do a freight run, I reckon, now. And then I'll have another look at the comment section. But yeah, overall, enjoying the game. Enjoying the steamies. Wait a minute. Can I do what I think I can do? Will it let you do it? I don't think it will. Ah. I was hoping it would let you repaint a Jubilee. I could have repainted one into DR Green. Oh, that's sad. Never mind. But I can at least do scenario planning. So let's do... what scenarios, actually? I don't normally do the scenarios. Maybe I should do one in the 8F. Maybe? I might just do another free roam. I need quite a few of these, though. I'm not sure. What do you guys, Oh, you can actually... Oh, hello. You can actually just sort out concepts. Well, come on then, Train Sim. When are you going to give us a tank engine to do shunting with scenarios like that? Please? Hehe. That is a free roam scenario, though. I think I will... I did say, oh, yeah, in the comments, but I think I might just do another little free roam. Oh, I just missed it. Ah, oh, and I can. Right, we're going to look at that quickly then. I'm going to do that. Someone said it was at the bottom. Oh, I see. They're listed, like, weirdly. Ah, there it is. Oh, I get it. LPC. I don't know. Let's call it stuff. Let's just give this a go. Edit. Oh no! Don't do this to me! Oh my god, no! No! I think we can do Crimson Lake. Wait a minute. Oh, tender. Yeah. I can actually paint this. Okay. That is like... I don't even know. Add new layer. Text. Where does the text appear? Do you know what? I'm not even gonna go there. I'm not skilled with this editor. I'm not even gonna attempt that, but I'm sure somebody out there will and can share with me a file how to do that. But that's fine. You can do that. That is a thing you can do. I don't want tools. I want to go to explore. I want to take the AF out for a run. We'll do it at a different time of year. We'll do it in like March. We'll do it in light cloud with lots of cloud, lots of wind. I guess I'm doing that one. I didn't even look what it was. I didn't even see what it was. Riley's asking why I'm in the recording booth, because I'm doing this one on my own, Riley, because I'm trying to talk, trying to be serious. Yeah, someone put DR green. Just paint yeet. Anyway, oh goodness, what time of day is this? It's 4 a.m. No. I want to see what I'm doing during the stream. I will do a night shift another time. So let's try that again, shall we? So timetable, we want to do the 8F, we want to do it in March. Yeah, I'll just put the wind strength up, I guess. We want to do, I don't know, let's do, is there not a longer run we can do with the freight? Just edge hill to edge hill? Oh! Brake van tour? That doesn't sound, I was kind of hoping. That looks long enough. We'll do that. Probably picked the wrong time of day again. So we had a look at the Jubilee. Let's see how we get with the AF. Even though I think we've already found out I like the Jubilee. But AF, I think, is probably a little bit more. I don't know how to describe that. Why are these freight runs, like, really early in the morning when I can't see a finger? I want to see the engine. I've looked at it and I was like, oh, yeah, I can do that. And then I realised it was, like, really early in the morning. Yeah, anyway, yeah. Have they not got any long snows that happen during the day? Does that tell me what the distance is? No. Not really a lot of options then, is there? It's all like late at night for the longer runs. 2:05. Yeah, that's 2:05 in the morning, isn't it? Yeah. The longest run I can do during the day... it's going to be that. It takes 13 minutes. Okay. You know what? We're going to do that. We'll just do that. Okay? We're going to do that. Because then I can wrap up. Because we've seen the route. We've seen the engines that are involved. We know that I've enjoyed it. And I'm hoping other people enjoy it if they pick it up. But this has been my... honest review of Train Sim World 2's thingy. I didn't even know what I was saying then. Train Sim World 2's crew to Liverpool. I will say these engines are very slippy. Because I've literally just attempted to leave. I've not even got much reg or reverser. So this isn't a very long journey, but at least it gives us time to look at the AF. Which does look very grubby. Very workmanlike. very much. Very freight. Very love. Good thing about stallion machines as well, and I'm pretty sure it's partly one of the reasons why Dovetail included two stallion logos, is that their cabs are basically the same. I'd like dampers open. Do I do the rear dampers as well? I'll do both dampers, it's fine. No, I won't. I don't need the rear dampers on, I'm not in reverse. Have I got a fire lad? Ah! I haven't got a fire lad! One does not have a fireman on this journey. Whoops. I keep wanting to press Control R for the auto fireman. Why haven't I got a fire lad? I'm really concerned about that. How long is the freight train anyway? Not super long. Why do I recognise those trucks? They look like Ashton trucks. A little bit. Everyone, see that? Look, watch the driving wheels. Look, when you get too far away, they stop animating. What? Look, watch the driving wheels if you can. Hang on. Look, they just stop animating when you get too far away. That is really weird. That is really weird. I didn't notice that earlier, but now I've seen it, I can't unsee it. We're not doing very well for pressure, are we? Because I ain't got a fire lad. Which means I'll probably run out of water as well. Whoops. Have a look at some of the details while we're going along. We're really not doing so well this time. Hmm. Well, at least it's a freight engine. It's only meant to sort of do short trips. I say short. What do I mean? Slow. Blower fully on. Another 8F there. Very good. Get down and dirty with that little valve gear. I don't think I'll probably do a trip up the West Somerset on a demonstration freight with this thing at some point. It's kind of mesmerising, isn't it? even if I'm driving incredibly poorly. He's not going to get any non-points for going over the speed limit, I suppose. No idea what's going on there. What's our pressure doing anyway, as in on there? Less than 150, no way. Come on, Mr. Blower. Get us our pressure back. Do wish I could close this little vent, that'd be cool. But after joy driving steam engine, you have to be at the back. Did have the fire, I think I'm on, let me have a look, what did I have it on, oh I do have it on manual, that's why, assisted, let's do assisted then, that might help, I think assisted, yeah, because I did have the firebox open, that's strange. You think got that traditional, like, you know, clanking. I like that. Regardless of the boiler pressure, I'm on a gradient. I'm going to have to... going to have to do something about it. Lamps. No, I thought we could do lamps. Doesn't matter, this is all stuff I will work out eventually. So, when it's gone a little bit quiet now, we've had the exciting bit. So, we're now at the slightly quieter bit of the stream where I finish this little bit and then probably wrap up there. But, I mean, how far have we actually got in this whole... I don't know, but we'll have a look in a minute. Of course, having it on assisted means I can't operate them, but it's fine. You can pick up speed. As we approach probably what is going to be end up being the end of this particular run. Which is a shame, I'd like to run an 8F man down the entire line. Maybe another day. Look, with that motion blur. Looks quite cool, doesn't it? Wish the main line was a bit busier, though. Now I'm getting an awful lot of lag. And here we are, having to slow down because we've got a limit coming up. Well, I've ruined that. Don't know whether it's the motion blur that's done it, but I'm getting a lot of lag. Or it could be the area. Oh, there are the conflats that Richard was talking about in the chat. So there we go, everyone. As we come to the end of this this particular scenario, on this short hop with the 8F, and with the Jubilee, of course, earlier on, I've said pretty much everything I want to say, so I'm going to do my final roundup of this. bearing in mind that a lot of people have watched, and hopefully a lot of people will watch, and hopefully people will look at this and form their own opinion on what they've seen today. I think it's decent. It's definitely somewhere in the middle of the road. It's great to see the steam engines. Nice to see a steam era route. Would have been nice to have more steam engines, but hopefully we'll see them in time. I think the route could be a little bit better. But overall, I think it's sort of, you know, middle of the road. Definitely middle of the road, I would say. I have enjoyed my time with this, and I think I will continue to enjoy Train Sim World with the steam. So, yeah, I think that's all really I've got to say. I think I'm going to end it here. Because I've only got to go, like, what, 700 yards? I think. I'm not sure, actually. Do I have to only go 700 yards? Not sure. But you know what? I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna set the because we've got to go up the line. I'm gonna do an outro here, everyone. So middle of the road. I've enjoyed it, and I probably will still enjoy it. Thank you, DTG, for bringing steam engines into Train Sim World. I'm hoping you're gonna bring more routes, more locos, and hope you hear my advice about maybe opening it up for third party in the future, perhaps. Good luck with the auto fireman, the actual fireman anyway, so we can all do it. I've learned a fair little few bits today. That's always good. It's nice to learn. So, all I can say really is thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And I hope you can make your mind up whether you like Train Sim World 2's Spirit of Steam. I'm sure I will come to love it. Thank you everybody for watching. And if I can get my camera to work properly, I will see you all next time. Goodbye.